Hey everyone, I'm quickly answering a common question I get online about my export settings for stock footage in Adobe Premiere Pro.
The best way to show you is with Adobe Premiere Pro. Here I have an example drone clip on a 4K 24 frames per second timeline, which is how I provide my stock footage for purchase. This export is different to exporting it for Facebook, YouTube or Instagram. I'll be exporting it in a way that the file and bitrate will be as close to the original source file as possible. To start, I generally give the clip a very basic color correction and edit. I like to provide the footage as natural as possible so other editors can add their own color and mix it into their existing movies. So simple white balance, contrast, highlights and shadow corrections. I also have my own LUT, which I sometimes use to make it quick and easy for me. Once it's ready to export, I mark the in and out points. Then I head over to the export menu, and this is where all the magic happens. I select H.264, give it a name and location to save the file to. If there is no audio, I deselect the audio button. I then double check that the output and source file information is correct and looks good for export. Clicking on Match Source will fix any issues here with output and source. I then make sure Render at maximum depth is checked. Scrolling down under Profile, I select High, then head down to Bitrate Settings. This is probably the most important section of the export. I prefer VBR2 Pass. There are better videos and forums online that explain what VBR2 variable bitrate is, so check them out online if you need more explanation. I've created a playlist, so check the description below. I follow the simple formula when I try to determine the target and maximum bitrate for stock footage. First, go to the original video file that you're using for the export. Look in the properties of the file, look for the data rate. Mine here is 100279 kilobits per second. If you remove the last three digits, this will convert to megabits. I have a 100 megabit video. So the target bit rate I change to 100. For the maximum bit rate, I multiply the 100 by 1.4, which gives me 140 megabit per second video. That's right, you can go a little bit more than the source bit rate without damaging the file or introducing noise into the compression. In fact, if you search online, you can go up to 1.6 from the source file without any issue. For me, I have been doing the 1.4 rule for some time, and I generally keep the target close to the original. This is just my personal preference for exporting. A friend of mine who exports clips for TV uses the CBR format and applies the 100 source file bitrate to the export. And another editor I know uses QuickTime option and selects Apple ProRes HQ, which also works well, but you get a ridiculously large file, around 2 gigs for every 10 to 20 seconds of footage. For my business and the companies that I work with, the variable bitrate VBR2 pass works well for me and gives me a reasonable file size at the highest quality. I then make sure the maximum render quality is ticked and I queue the file for encoding in Adobe Media Encoder. I then repeat the process for each stock video clip.
Hope that helps you to sell high quality stock footage. I will link a playlist below in the description of some of my favorite YouTubers who have their best export settings for stock footage. If you want to check them out, until next time, thanks for watching and let me know if you have any comments below.